Hello, Tor Lacey here, with a quick discussion about the effect weathering has on minerals and rocks. Our main learning objective is to be able to describe what happens physically and chemically to mineral grains as they mature and use the maturity of grains to make interpretations about geologic history. Weathering is essentially the breakdown of rock and the minerals making up rocks through mechanical and chemical processes. Mechanical weathering breaks up rock into smaller pieces called grains without changes to the overall composition of the rock. For example, frost wedging, a mechanical weathering process, cracks up bedrock into grains. These grains are simply smaller pieces of the bedrock, having the same overall composition. With time, mechanical weathering matures grains by decreasing their size and changing their shape from angular to more rounded. In contrast, chemical weathering does change the composition of rock. This change in composition happens because of chemical reactions, which dissolve minerals or transform minerals from one type to another. These changes weaken the framework of the rock, causing it to break down. With time, chemical weathering matures the mineral grains by decreasing the overall variety of minerals in a rock. The unweathered rock will contain a more heterogeneous assemblage of minerals versus the same rock that has been weathered, which will have a more homogeneous group of minerals. For example, a rock with a variety of iron and magnesium minerals will weather to one that is richer in quartz and clay over time. These are three photographs of sedimentary rocks containing increasingly mature sediment. Note how grain size, grain angularity, and grain variety all decrease with time. I hope you enjoyed this discussion about the maturing of mineral grains over time. Thank you for listening.